Do you know what the Fileprivate function is? Or how about an open class? If not, then you're in luck, because today we are going to tackle access control. I'm Alex from Rebeloper.com, and this tutorial we are going to go through all the access levels. Now, if you do like this video, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and also hit the like. And let's open up Xcode. Let's dive in. You might have seen private, open, or even file private thrown around in Swift code, but you don't really know what to do with that, or you don't really know what that actually means. Well, you're in luck, because today we are going to cover all of that. I'm going to go through all of the basics, and then we are going to have a hands-on example in Xcode. Before we dive into that, let me remind you about DevFactory. It is at rebeloper.com/mentoring. A 60-minute Zoom call with me. If you have any questions about Swift UI, Swift in general, I'm available for you with a Zoom meeting. Now, if you have a bug in your code, if you want to talk with me, I'm also available for that. Again, it's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. So let's just jump right into it. And I have prepared a keynote for this. So what is access control? Well, access control is Swift's model of accessing files and functions and classes and all of the properties on a grained level. So what it means is that you may access them or you may not, or at a certain level. Now, Swift's access control model is based on the concept of modules and source files. Now, these two concepts are really important for you to grasp. So what are modules? Well, a module is a single unit of code distribution that can be imported by another module with Swift import keyword. Think about like a framework of, Swift UI, for example, or foundations or UIKit. That is a module. Another module is also your app, so the project that you are working on. Now, what are source files? A source file is a single Swift source code file within a module. In effect, a single file within an app or a framework. So a module, again, is some big distribution of code, and a source file is just one file. Okay, so what are the Swift access levels? Well, there are five: open, public, internal, Fileprivate, and private. Now, open access is the highest, the least restrictive access level, and private access is the lowest access level, meaning it is the most restrictive. So it comes from open till private. So let's go through these. So open and public, they're kind of the same, and we are going to talk about them in the example, what's kind of the differences. But open access and public access enable entities to be used within any source file from their defining module. So, and also if you import them, import the module into your own module, then you will be able to access them. So that's kind of open and public. Internal access enables entities to be used within any source file from their defining module. So you are kind of working on your own project, and you don't really set any open or file private or private functions, then those are internal. And those cannot be accessed through other modules. So outside of that module, they cannot be accessed. Fileprivate. Now, Fileprivate access restricts the use of an entity to its own defining source file. So whenever you set something to Fileprivate, it will be accessible only on that source file. Okay, private. Again, private access restricts to the use of an entity to the enclosing declaration and the extensions of that declaration. So if you declare a class private, then all of its entities, be it functions or properties, will be private to that class only. They will not be able to be accessed outside of that class. So here are some guiding principles. And we are going to talk about these two in detail in just a second with the hands-on example. So all entities in your code have a default access level of internal if you don't specifically set up access level for yourself. So whenever you type func or class or just a variable, they are kind of inferred implicitly to be internal. If you have a top, like a parent entity that has some other type of access level, then it will infer that also, and you will see this in the example. Now, the second rule is that no entity can be defined in terms of another entity that has a lower, like meaning more restrictive access level. But this means if you have set up a public class, for example, you cannot have, for example, private functions in them. So we will see that in the example above. And there we go. We want to know a project. Well, yeah, these two things that I want to share before we are going into the hands-on example. When you write a simple single target app, that's what we usually do, the code in your app is typically self-contained within the app and doesn't need to be made available outside of the app's module. So that's why you rarely use this if you are writing just a single app. So you want the classes, functions to be available throughout your app. Now, if you are writing, for example, a framework, when you are developing it, when you are marking the public facing interface of the framework as open or public, those will be available for other modules when you import this framework into your own module. So yeah, we are going to talk about that also. So let's take a look at a hands-on example on an Xcode project for the syntax of how we are actually going to write this out. Okay, so I have opened up a brand new Swift UI project and I have added two files here, access control 1 and access control 2. So let's just start typing out some of these access controls. So first, and I will just move this, well, let's just go into access control 1. I'm using this access control 1 and 2 because I want to give you an example when Fileprivate is used. So let's just have some public class and let's just go with public and the class and some public class. Okay, so let's just have that. So this is a public class. It will be available throughout your app. So if I just go and type here like some public class, as you can see, it's all we can automatically complete with that. Okay, so now let's have an internal class. So that's kind of the next level. So internal, and again, class. So this some internal class will also be available in our project because we are in the same module. So let's just go some internal class. There we go. We have access to it. Now let's create a file private class. So file private class and some file private class. Okay. So this is a file private class, meaning that it should not be accessible on the other file. So let's just have some, and as you can see, we don't have this. So if you just type out file private class, then this class may not be available in this context, which is really true. Okay, so finally we have private. And it does the same. So in this case, this private classes entities would not be available on other classes, even though they are on the same file. So that's kind of private. Okay, these are classes, but we can go with variables and constants. So let's just have here a public, there we go, and that's zero. And this will be accessible throughout our app because it's set to public. So let's just go with some, there we go, some public variable. We may access that. Let's just have an internal constant because that's kind of the same. Of course, this will again be available. I'm not going to show you that. Now, let's create a fileprivate function because also functions can be created with these access levels. And of course, this will not be accessible right over here. So some fileprivate function, as you can see, it's not accessible. And also, let's create a private function. And now we have some private function. And that's nice. So these are kind of the public, internal, fileprivate, and private functions. We are going to talk about, not just functions, access control elements. So we are going to talk about the open in at the end of the video. So make sure you just check that out also. So we have this internal right over here. And you usually just go like, let me just copy this out and just go class and have a class there and just give it a name and just initialize it. This is how you would just usually do. And that, let me just comment this out, that infers that this is internal. So whenever you don't write anything beforehand, in this case, the class, then it infers that this is internal. And the same goes for the sum, let me just correct that to the sum internal constant. So if we just move this, let me just remove the class also, and then remove the internal, it all works perfectly fine. So this will just actually work. Now, as we take a look right over here, let's take a look at this. All entities in your code have a default access level of internal. This is what I was talking about. But the next one is no entity can be defined in terms of another entity that has a lower access level. Now, let's take a look at that. What does that actually mean? Well, I have prepared here some examples so you better understand how this works. And these are the actual examples. So let's say we have a public class, and yeah, I have named them the same as right over here, so I just comment that out. Okay, so we have this some public class. It's a public, so all of its properties or functions may be public, internal, file private, and private. And of course, the internal is implicitly internal. Now, this some internal class is defined internal explicitly, implicitly. So we may have here an internal, file private, and private. And as you can see, we cannot have a public. We don't see anything here as public. If we try to add that, we cannot. Also, for the file private, we might have here an implicit file private and private. Also, for the private, we might have an implicit private function. So that's kind of what I wanted to tell you about this. So there's kind of a narrowing of accessibility if we just go down till the private. So yeah, that is kind of the second rule that I was talking about. Now let's talk a little bit about the open, because we talked about the public, but there's also open, kind of the most unrestrictive way of handling our classes and our entities. Next, let's talk a little bit about subclassing, because if we have a public class and it has a file private, let's see how that actually works like. So let's create a public class of A. Okay, and this public class will have a file private function, and that's it. Let's just have that created. So now we have a class. Now we want to subclass it. Let's say let's create a class called B, and that is subclassing A. And let me just have some more room here so we can watch it. Now we can actually override the sum method. So let's just go type sum method, and as you can see, it's auto-completing and it will override the sum method. And we can also have a super dot sum method. So whenever, first of all, we want to take care of this implementation, and then we are going to do whatever we want after that. So also note that these are all internal, but they are added, they are implicit there. So also the class and the function. We could just add in here internal if we wanted to, also before the class. Now, why does this work? Well, let's just take a look at these two classes. First of all, the class A is public, so we may access, subclass it from class B. Of course, this could be Fileprivate or so, or internal, because we are on the same module. But nonetheless, this internal class is subclassing class A. So B is subclassing A. Now, here we have a Fileprivate function, and therefore, because we are inside this file, so in the access control one file, we may override it as an internal, of course, for our own convenience. So that is why, even though this is file private, we can access it because we are on the same file. Now, if we have moved all of this file, let me just comment it out and paste it right over here, this will not work. Actually, the internal will not work. Let me just comment this out and hit command B. Now, we may subclass class A into B because it's public, or it could be internal also, but we may not override its file private sum method function. That's why it would not work right over here. So let's just go back and add it right over there. So there's our class B subclassing class A. And this is how you want to think about this. Now, finally, let's talk about open. So let's create our open class. Open, and let's have a class of maybe C. And right over here, let's just have a function of some method. Okay, so this is our open class. What this means is that and some method needs to have an implementation. Okay, so what open means is that we can override it anywhere. So in another module, or in, let's say, in the next file. So what I'm going to do is right over here, create a class, and let's just call this D, and I'm going to subclass C. As you can see, it is available. And then I can access some method. And as you can see, it's overriding it, and it is internal. So if we wanted to subclass also D on another module, we would need to have this as open also. And also, we can just go super sum method because we are using on open for our classes. And basically, that's it. You want to make sure that you understand how modules and source files communicate all of this access control. So it's based on these two concepts, modules and source files. And just to recap, we have five access levels: open, public, internal, file private, and private. Now, if you do like these types of videos, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a one-on-one 60-minute Zoom call where I can teach you Swift UI or Swift, or if you have a bug in your code, I can help you with that. Now, remember, it's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. So now you know how you can fine-tune your access levels for your functions, classes, and properties. Now, if you do like these types of videos, go ahead and smash that like button. It helps a lot for this channel. Now, while you're at it, make sure to also hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos. New videos like this one, go ahead and check them out. Also, my channel, I post a lot of Swift UI videos. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.